Let's talk about naming anhydrides. So an anhydride is a priority group. On our chart here, it is the second highest priority group. It will subjugate any group below it in the table with its subordinate group prefix, and we're not going to use a subordinate group prefix for anhydrides in the presence of carboxylic acids, as we'll see in just a moment why. We're going to follow our general strategy of circling the parent chain, writing the name of the subordinate groups that intersect that parent chain, we'll number the chain, and assemble the name for and check for stereochemistry as we do that. One quick note, alkenes and alkynes will be included in suffix form and do not have subordinate group names when they are included in the parent chain. Okay, so we'll have examples of those in other videos discussing these priority functional groups. So let's look at anhydride specifically here, and when that anhydride is the highest priority group and nothing else is present. So what we're going to do is name each side and see as a carboxylic acid and then put the total name together. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, we've got propanoic on either side. So if these were carboxylic acids, they would be named as propanoic acid, but since they are an anhydride and a symmetrical anhydride at that, we will call this propanoic anhydride. Now for our second, we have a non-symmetrical or unsymmetrical anhydride, and again, three carbons, 1, 2, and 3, starting with the carbonyl, 1, 2, and 3. On one side, we still have propanoic, would be acid if it weren't an anhydride, but here we have a 2-chloro propanoic side. When we put the name together in alphabetical order for an unsymmetrical anhydride, the C comes before P, so we have a 2-chloro propanoic, second word, propanoic, third word, anhydride. So overall here, we see a 2-chloropropanoic propanoic anhydride. Anytime you have an unsymmetrical anhydride, you just name each side as its own carboxylic acid here, and then put the names together in separate words, alphabetical order, followed by a separate word, anhydride, at the end. When there are multiple anhydrides present, it gets a little bit complicated, but what we want to do is name it like a dioic acid and then the individuals on the end. So here we have ethanoic, and on the other end we have an ethanoic end, and in the middle we have our dioic acid derivative, 1, 2, and 3, so that would be a propane dioic acid if it were its carboxylic acid form. So instead, here for the full name, we would have an alphabetical order, a diethanoic propane dioic anhydride. And the reason we don't include anhydride group name here in the presence of its only higher priority group in our course that we're going to see is a carboxylic acid is because of the tendency that we could see the carbonyl form here and the nucleophilic lone pair potentially attack one of these carbonyls to form a tetrahedral intermediate and end up kicking off this other group. So in other words, anhydrides are reactive with carboxylic acids, and so we won't see that in nomenclature.